Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. For those of you who enjoy the macabre, I'm going to show you how to add a name to this nameless, long-forgotten gravesite headstone. I provided this gravestone for you to download so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video's description or project files. This document is 1280 by 720 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using Old Style 1. If you'd like to use it, I provided that link as well. For the top line, I'm using a size of 40 points, smooth, center alignment, and black for the color. Type out your text. If you'd like some lines to be larger or smaller, highlight those lines and type in a different point size. Click on your Move tool to center your text over the gravestone. Go to Layer, Rasterize, and Type. Change the Blend Mode to Multiply and the Fill to 50%. Reducing the fill's opacity makes the text more transparent without reducing the opacity of the effects that we'll be adding to the text. Double-click on the thumbnail to open the Layer Style window. Click Inner Shadow. Make the Blend Mode Color Burn and the Opacity 15%. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle 138 degrees. Make the distance 4 pixels and the size 0. Click Drop Shadow and make the Blend Mode Soft Light. Click on the color box and pick White. Make the opacity 100%, the distance 3 pixels and the size 3 pixels. Then click OK. Since the headstone is a bit angled in perspective, our text needs to be angled as well. We can do this with the Vanishing Point feature, but in this case, it's just simpler to use the Transform tool. Press Ctrl or Command T to open it. Go to bottom left of the Transform and press and hold Ctrl on a PC or Command on a Mac and drag it a little closer to the left corner. Go to the bottom right of the Transform, press Ctrl or Command and drag it to a position that brings the bottom of the Transform parallel to the bottom of the inside box of the headstone. Go to the top left of the Transform and drag it to a position that makes the entire Transform be in the same perspective as the entire headstone. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll transform it from day to night and strike it with a sliver of moonlight. Make a composite snapshot of your existing image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on a PC or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. We'll name it Composite. Let's zoom out to see more room around the image. Press Z to open your Zoom tool and press and hold Alt or Option as you click down to zoom out. Click on your Quick Mask button and open your Brush tool. Make the size 400 pixels, the hardness 0, and the opacity 100%. Press F5 to open your brush window and uncheck all the features except smoothing. Press F5 again to close the window. Brush in a diagonal line across the center of your image. To fit it back on your screen, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, we'll remove the quick mask that's above the headstone. Reduce your brush size to 10 pixels, then press Enter or Return. Invert the foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Click down on the top left corner of the headstone, then go to the top right corner and press and hold Shift as you click down once. This removes a straight soft line from your quick mask. Make your brush size a little larger by pressing on the right bracket key on your keyboard. Now, brush out the rest of your quick mask on the top. Let's make the bottom of the quick mask a bit transparent. Reduce the opacity to 60% and make the brush size 250 pixels. Now, brush across the bottom of your document once. Press Q to change the quick mask into a selection. Click on your adjustment layer button and choose Color Lookup. This was introduced in CS6. If you're working on an earlier version of Photoshop, I'll show you in a minute another way to achieve similar results. Notice the adjustment layer's layer mask includes the shape of the selection. Open Load 3D LUT and choose Moonlight 3DL. The reason we're getting a streak of light is because the layer mask is revealing the composite layer under it. Now, I'll show you how to achieve similar results without using Color Lookup. Before we clicked on Color Lookup, we had an active selection that we made from the quick mask. Save the selection by going to Select and Save Selection. Then click OK. Click on the thumbnail of the composite layer to make it active. Press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy of it, and then hide the copy. Make the original composite layer active and click on the Adjustment Layer button. Choose Levels and make the output white level 130. To adjust the color cast, click on the Adjustment Layer button again and this time choose Hue Saturation. Check Colorize and make the hue 220 and the saturation 70. Reduce the opacity to 50%. Make the composite copy visible and active. Open the Channels panel and Control-click or Command-click on Alpha 1 to make the channel into a selection. Open back up your Layers panel and click on the Layer Mask button to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Have fun placing your own text on a small granite gravestone that looks like it's been lit by a full moon filtered through trees. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.